choices of what you can be doing on Sunday evenings, but I think it's a special time to be here at Rockville Church. We've got about 30 folks who have put a lot of time and effort and energy into producing this this stage spectacular, and I'm so glad you're here for it. I want to thank Linda Helms and all those who have put a lot of hours into making this happen. And what a surprise it was to me to see this set come together, because I've never seen anything like this at Rockville Church in my time here. The play is short to come. What we will do to begin our evening is to sing the first verse together of Joy to the World.
Thank you. about Howdy, folks.
We're here to tell you a story.
This here is a country story.
Well, actually, it's about some city kids.
Who found themselves in the country on Christmas Eve.
Yeah, there were two kids who, just because they were from the city, thought they knew everything.
You know how them six look as well.
But during Christmas, they heard something they had never heard before.
It was a story.
So this is really a story in a story.
And it all happened in the country.
I hate this. There's nothing to do out here. There's not even a TV or a VCR.
There's not a mall or a movie theater within 100 miles of here. I'm bored stiff.
These people are nice to let us stay here. What's up with them calling everybody cousin?
Yeah, that's so weird.
The next time somebody comes up to me and says, howdy, cousin.
Howdy, cousin.
Say, Cousin Daniel, you alien.
No, not exactly.
Well, I'll have Granny fix you up a dozen castor oil and a fix you up in the jiffy.
Oh, please, no. I'll be okay.
If you say so.
Hey, Cousin Daniel, want me down to the creek to catch some crawdads?
No, thanks.
All right.
Hey, Cousin Chelsea.
Hey, that's just Chelsea.
Oh, I mean just Chelsea. You want to go climb some trees with me?
I don't think I'm dressed for climbing.
I got some overalls you can wear. They're my Sunday pair. But I don't mind if you wear them.
No, I think not.
All righty.
Hey, Cousin, you want them
now?
No. We don't want to be rude, but me and Chelsea feel, well, a little misplaced out here in the boonies. We'd like to get back to the city before Christmas.
Yeah, what's so special about the city anyhow?
There's always something to do.
No, it's so cool. There's always something to do.
Things really happen, you know. This is how Christmas is in the city. Party with the parents.
That's where you're heading for when our car comes out.
So you don't got to write a read a Christmas story?
A Christmas story, like it was the night before Christmas and off to the house.
No, like it came, like the Bible story. It came to pass in new days of Nero and Audi decreed from Caesar Augustus.
Never heard of that Christmas story.
Me either.
It's from the Bible.
Every Christmas Eve, we gather around and we decorate the cedar tree with cranberries and popcorn. And Uncle Yule reads the Christmas story.
Ooh, exciting.
Uncle Yule, what kind of name is that?
It's short for Yuletide. See, he was born on Christmas Day just like Jesus.
Like Jesus?
I don't know if I believe that. And I still don't believe you have an Uncle Yuletide.
In the flesh and at your service.
Hello, you, Uncle Yule.
I heard you had company, some cousins or something.
How's your cousins?
Back there is Cousin Daniel and Cousin Chelsea.
It's Jess Chelsea.
I forgot. Her name's Jess Chelsea.
They're just spending Christmas with us.
Oh, please, no.
Nice to make your acquaintance. Your mom and pa are here, too?
They're around here somewhere.
Our father's trying to get someone to fix the car.
Which may be impossible on Christmas Eve.
And our mom's trying to nurse a migraine.
Well, whereabouts y'all from?
We were heading to an office party when our car broke down. Now we're going to miss Christmas altogether.
Well, we do have Christmas out here, too, you know. Of course, we have to order an air and sunshine from a catalog, but we do have Christmas.
That's a good number, you know.
Very funny.
And well, it may be Christmas here, but it won't be Christmas like it should be.
Well, I don't know about that now. Christmas is a country holiday, you know.
What?
Oh, sure. That first Christmas happened in a little bitty country town, a place called Bethlehem. Group up here, youngers. I'll tell you about it. All right, kids. I'm going to sing mine. Y'all sing back. Y'all ready?
Oh, you mean sing a song?
I don't know. Our music wouldn't translate that. you wouldn't understand it.
Well, what kind of songs do you sing, cousin?
Yeah, they have songs we sing.
Not at all.
Very different.
Different, like how?
Larger's a song sound.
Cool.
Okay.
Granny's cornbread really twangs my buds.
Well, come on, you youngest. We gotta go in and wash up and help you put it on the table.
Come on, Luther. Chelsea.
I don't hear it, but
me neither.
You can sit by me.
No.
All right,
Jim Shell, come on,
for me. There's hog dowels and cornbread. Just wait to twang your buds.
Oh, Daniel, what are we going to do? I can't take it. I'm starving. Who knows when we'll get out of here?
Me too.
Come on, youngins. Granny says the vittles is getting cold. Hey now, what you bawling for?
Well, Chelsea's homesick.
I guess everybody don't take to our country cooking and country ways.
I'm not trying to be rude, just maybe the babies just aren't me.
I understand. I guess we didn't exactly fit into your plans. Kind of like that first Christmas, I reckon.
Really?
Oh, sure. The first Christmas, you know, bad enough that Lord of Lords being born in that little one horse town, place called Bethlehem, but for him to have to spend his first night in a barn, well, folks had a hard time settling.
Is that really the way it was?
Yes, sir, it sure was. Of course, that was God's plan all along. Caught the rest of the world off their guard. They didn't expect to meet the Savior in a barn.
Really?
Oh, yeah. You'd be surprised what might happen out in the boonies. Hey, you kids like peanut butter and jelly?
Yeah.
Sure.
Come on in the house. I reckon we find something fit to eat. Come on.
And he be sitting on a throne, but there he was.
Them city slickers got a gift for the new gospel.
I expect it is.
I'm really sorry we made fun of all the country stuff.
Yeah, we're sorry. I mean, it isn't so bad out here. It's kind of quiet and peaceful.
Everybody's real nice.
Well.
Can I
go? Hey, cousin Andrew, baby Chelsea. Follow your car, say you got the car here.
Yeah, you guys will be back in time for Christmas.
Great.
Yeah. What's the matter?
I thought you was all fired up to get back to the city in time for Christmas. Cousin Chelsea. Just Chelsea.
It's okay, Cormier. You can call me cousin if you like.
You mean it?
Yes, I mean it.
Hey, Chelsea, you think God will let us stay and figure this huge thing was in our Christmas store one more time?
I suppose so. I mean, I reckon.
Stay to decorate the tree and to hear the Christmas story again.
In fact, their mom and pa seemed to enjoy themselves too.
Their dad forgot about the office party he was missing.
And their mom forgot about her headache.
That night, they all gathered around and Uncle Yule prayed, thanking God for bringing them all together.
And then Sadie Slicker said the real Christmas story for the first time.
You know, it's hard to believe there are people out there who don't know the Christmas story.
You know, it's hard. I reckon there's somebody here that ain't heard it before, or that needs to hear it again anyways.
So let's tell it again.
And it came to pass in those days that there went a decree from Caesar Augustus that all of the world should be taxed, and all went to be taxed, everyone in his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be taxed with his espoused wife, being with the child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room in the inn.
And there were in the same country shepherds.
See, there were country shepherds.
Shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by day. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. The angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in the manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
And it came to pass as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary, Joseph, and the babe lying in a manger.
The story about the city kids in the country, well, it may or may not have really happened.
But the other story, the story about the Savior being born, it did happen.
He was a real baby with a real special purpose. He was God's son, and he came to make us all brothers and sisters in him, not distant cousins.
And that's the story we came to tell y'all.
Now go and tell it to somebody else.
And tell them how it all happened in the country.
Thank you.
been asked to make a few remarks here, which a preacher doesn't usually shy away from. I just want to say first that a few months ago, this idea was hatched. For those of y'all who know Rockville Church well, we don't always think in terms quite this grand. And I was one of the ones who said, well, I don't know, this sounds a little like maybe next year we can pull off something like this. Maybe next year. But I just want to say such a big thanks to Linda Helms, who really made this happen and had.
Amen.